Class 4, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 10, our environment and pollution. So first of all, we will discuss about our environment, then we will study about the pollution. So environment, what is an environment? Environment is comprised of all living and non-living things that occur naturally on the earth. So environment means it consists of both living and non-living things like human beings, animals, plants, these are living things, mountains, rivers, soil, land, these are non-living things. So environment is composed of all living and non-living things. So our surrounding, that is also a part of the environment, schools, houses, parks, markets, our neighbors, our family members, other people, they make up our immediate physical environment. The people, those who live around us, our schools, houses, our neighbors, even our family members, they make up the physical environment. So animals and plants also have their environment, like we are having our environment, humans are having their environment, animals and plants also have their environment. The environment of a squirrel includes the sun, the air it breathes, the food it eats, the water it drinks, the tree it lives on, and the other plants and animals around it. Similarly, if we will consider fish consists of the river or lake it lives in, the food it finds there in the water, the plants and animals found in water, it is its environment, fish environment. So the surroundings are the part of the environment. Those whoever are there in our surrounding, that is our environment. Like when we are living in our surrounding, we have houses, we have parks, we have schools, we have trees, then sky, sun. So all these are our environment. So environment is very important because it gives us many basic needs. Environment is very important because it gives us many basic needs. Like now you might have questioned that what does environment give us? So we are dependent on environment for our basic needs such as shelter, clothes, food and water. All these things comes from the environment. The food what we eat, that is comes from plants and animals. Milk, eggs and meat are obtained from the animals, and we get fruits, vegetables, pulses, cereals from the plants. Even medicines are also produced from the seeds, leaves and barks of some plants that have medicinal value. So some plants and animals give us fiber, which is used to make clothes we wear, like cotton, silk. Then paper obtained from trees is used for making books, newspaper, magazines. So all these things, we are depending on the environment for all the basic needs like shelter, clothes, food and water. Animals also depend on their environment for their basic needs. Monkeys live on trees, birds make nests on trees with leaves, twigs and sticks which they found in their environment. So environment is very important because it gives us our basic needs, so it satisfies our basic needs like shelter, clothes, food and water. The environment gives us the everything that supports our survival. It provides us everything like food, shelter, clothes, water, which is important for our survival, that supports our survival. So therefore, keeping and maintaining environment clean and neat is our responsibility. It is our responsibility that we should take care of the environment. Unfortunately, many of our activities are adversely affecting the environment. Instead of taking care for the environment, many of our activities are affecting the environment. There are many activities that affect the environment, like we are throwing carelessly empty packets, cans, bottles, polythene bags and leftover food we are throwing carelessly here and there, contaminating the area by smoke and harmful gases emitted by vehicles, factories and burning garbage. We are running the vehicles, factories and we are burning the garbages, so the area, the atmosphere, the environment of that area is getting contaminated by the smoke and harmful gases. We are wasting resources such as water, electricity and petrol. In a great extent, we are wasting water, we are wasting electricity and we are wasting petrol. So when not in use, we can save the water, electricity and all, but instead of that, we are wasting more and saving less. For a healthy living, a clean environment is essential because any damage to the environment will directly or indirectly affect us and other living beings. such as plants and animals. So we should take care of the environment because it is important for a healthy living of a person. So all the animals, plants, they need a healthy life. So for healthy living, the environment should be neat and clean, and it is our responsibility to keep our environment neat and clean. We should take care of our environment. So we should take care of our environment, but nowadays various human activities are adding harmful substances to the environment. So the harmful substance that pollute air, pollution takes place when the harmful substances are getting added to the environment. That time pollution takes place, and the harmful substances that pollute the air, water and land, these are called pollutants. These are called pollutants. So the addition of the pollutants to the environment is called pollution. Addition of pollutants to the environment, that is called pollution. It causes undesirable changes in the air, water and soil. It damages the natural quality of the environment, and it adversely affects the health of all living organisms. So pollution means the addition of pollutants to the environment, that is called pollution. Pollution is also of three types: air pollution, land pollution and water pollution. So here we will discuss about the three types of pollution, that is air, land and water pollution. So first of all, we will discuss about the air pollution. So the addition of pollutants such as harmful gases, dust, fumes or smoke in the air, that is called air pollution. When pollutants like harmful gases, dust, fumes and smokes, they mix in the air, they causes air pollution. It can occur due to human activities or natural phenomenon like volcanic eruptions, pollen dispersal and forest fires. It contaminates the air. It contaminates the air present in the environment. So the pollutants in the air spread very fast and causes harm to all living organisms, because air is present everywhere. So it spreads very fast and it affects the all the living organisms. So the addition of harmful substances like harmful gases, dust, fumes or smokes in the air, that is called air pollution. If we will discuss the causes of air pollution, then there are a lot of factors causing air pollution. For example, first of all, we cut down trees for obtaining wood. Wood is used for constructing houses, for making paper and also for fuel. So the cutting down of trees on a large scale, that is called deforestation, and this leads to the lesser number of trees in the environment. When we cut down the trees, the number of trees in the environment is less, and lesser amount of oxygen is available. When trees are less, oxygen also is less, and this results in increase in the carbon dioxide in air, which leads to air pollution. When oxygen is decreasing, carbon dioxide is increasing and it causing air pollution. So the cutting down of trees is called deforestation. Burning of fuel. Next causes burning of fuel such as coal, petrol, diesel in vehicles and factories adds to the poisonous gases into the air and causes air pollution. So burning of fuels releases the poisonous gases into the air. Smoke coming out from the factories adds harmful gases like carbon dioxide into the air, which causes air pollution. Burning of firecrackers, then garbage, stubble is another cause for air pollution, because they also release some harmful gases. And then volcanic eruptions and forest fire release a large amount of smoke in the air, that causes air pollution. So if we will discuss the causes of air pollution, so first of all, when we cut down the trees, it leads to decrease in oxygen and increase in carbon dioxide, which is a cause of air pollution. Burning of fuels, then firecrackers, garbage and all, these all also causes air pollution. Smoke coming out from the factories also releases harmful gases, which causes air pollution. And volcanic eruptions, forest fire, they also release large amount of smoke, which causes air pollution. So this is about the air pollution and its causes. In the next class, we will discuss about its effect and prevention, and also we will discuss the land pollution. So till then, you read this and learn them.